Hopkins have the basketball as they double-team Matthews. Vander has it taken away, and here comes Boyd. Devisha Boyd with it. Right side as she'll pull up. Taylor will pick her up, stop the ball. Back to Williams it goes. Top of the key. Williams, 19-18. Kaskaskia has the lead. It's over to Hawkins. Wow. Late, little bit of late whistle, but Thompson will pick up the foul. As that is Michaela's second foul. A little scary there. Out front with it. That's going to bring Humphreys back in for Michaela. Over they go. Boyd underneath. She'll have it stripped, and Taylor comes up with it. She finds Vander. Vander looking for the separation. Turnover. As just a little miscommunication as Thompson starting to cut while Vander was leading her outside for the three. Kaskaskia to Williams. They'll bring it up. 9:19 left to go in the half. Spot tips it. Bree has it. There's Bree. Spins. Finds Lala underneath. It won't go. Shooting has been a little bit of a problem for the Lady Falcons up close as with the score, but the defense has not been a problem. Although they gave up 19 points, they were some well-earned points there for the Blue Angels. It is out front, over on the baseline, working on 10 seconds. It is Humphreys with the rebound. And here come the Lady Falcons. Bree scooting to the bucket. She'll pick up the contact. And let's see, it scared me for a second. It's still scaring me for a second. She hit her head pretty hard. And just for a second, little prayer for Bree Matthews. If she sits there very long, you know that's some scary stuff because that woman is fiery for sure. She's getting helped up, and then she's refusing to even acknowledge the fact that she may have fell down. But that's what you expect from that kind of young lady, Bree Matthews. Looks at the official, tells him exactly that she's fine, and you wouldn't expect anything different from number 10 for the Lady Falcons. Out of bounds under. She thought she was going the free throw line, as so did I. But Bree will take it out. She's still not acknowledging. Coach Trosper still trying to get her to acknowledge him. That's just Bree. She is a player. 19-18, the score, maybe just enough to foul call on the Lady Falcons. They got Humphreys, her first. Coming back into the game for the Lady for the Blue Angels is Engelkins. Finch, Engelkins, Boyd, Williams, and have to get back. It's Engelkins over to Williams. They go deep. Shot up, won't go. Battling. Wow, they get Finch on that. As it looks like a back-to-back fouls called away from the ball. Finch picks up foul number one. Fouls are two all here in the second quarter. Matthews, Taylor, Spot, Vander, and Humphreys for Coach Strasburg. Taylor has it as they key on Matthews. There's Jocelyn with it. As she brings it across, she's looking for Vander. Found her. Vander to the hoop, and Markayla Vander with a nifty little shot there. Gets on the book, and we have a 20-19 lead. Nearly a 10-second call after nearly a steal. It's Boyd back to Engelkins. Williams down the corner to Finch. Finch across to Boyd. Boyd with a two. Tipped by Taylor, and there's Lala. Big rebound. There's Spot. She takes it behind the back. She'll pull up at the volleyball line. Baseball pass on the bounce. Taylor has it. 19 left on the shot clock. There's Vander with three. In and out. Rebound brought down by Kaskaskia. Out ahead to Williams. Williams to Boyd. Boyd right side. Back to Williams. Williams sets it up. 22 on the shot clock. She'll go across to Engelkins. It's Taylor with a takeaway. Vander, and it's going to be a turnover. 2019 Falcons lead. 7:18 to go in the half, as it's going to be Kaskaskia's basketball out of bounds. Length of the floor to go. Still some pressure by the Lady Falcons. It is Williams back across the middle. They go back as barely got it across in time. Blocked shot, Humphreys. Taylor blocked it. Humphreys liked it, took it out of the air. Shot up. Humphreys goes hard to the boards, and Lala comes up with a big play. Here come the Lady Falcons. Bree off and running. Doesn't get the contact. Lala gets the rebound, however, as she slides all across the floor. And you got to say, she came up wanting the basketball from her knees. It is Engelkins takes it to the hoop, and the lead changes as Engelkins makes the bucket. 21-20 is our score. Here comes Kate. She'll come in for, let's see, Taylor. As no one knew. It's Spot, Kate, Bree, Lala, and Vander for Coach Trosper. Stainer to Vander. Vander outside the arc. 21-20, Kaskaskia leads by one. Spot with it. She'll work on Engelkins. Goes to the hoop. Got whistled for the travel. And she'll turn it over. 21-20. Is our score. Kaskaskia with a one-point lead. 6:16 left to go in the half. Turnover by Kaskaskia, and that's why I love that pressure by the Lady Falcons. Gotta love that pressure. You're listening to us on WBQAM 1240. I'm Kelly Mason. Everybody back at the studio working on our production of this one, so God bless y'all and thank you. As Spot brings it into Kate. Kate with it. Kate at the volleyball line, goes right side. She goes to Spot. Foul call on. It was. Let's see. That one, wasn't quite sure exactly. It was on Kaskaskia. Kate finds Bree. Bree will clear it. 27 on the shot clock. She fires a three, doesn't go. Rebound brought down by the Blue Angels. Hawkins with it to Engelkins. She goes. Still 21-20 as the Blue Angels go to the free throw line. Humphreys goes hard to the boards. And Lady Falcons, everything going well for them except there's a little bit of a bucket coverage there as trouble getting their shots to fall. But the enthusiasm, everything else is good. Out to Kate. Kate with a two. Won't go, but there's Markayla. And she hit the board hard on that one. Markayla gets the bucket, and the Lady Falcons have the one-point lead. Across the top, they go to Williams. Back it is as steal by Matthews. Vander with it. She doesn't get the hoop, but, wow, neither did Bree. They do call a travel, and Williams is just as confused. Missed the foul, so they called a travel, basically, is how it goes. That's why Williams was so confused. It is Humphreys to Vander. Vander back to Kate. Kate checks it out. She'll back away, left side. She gets a high screen from Lala. Lala doesn't go. Rebound. Battle four. Kaskaskia will come down with it. And here come the Blue Angels. 22-21, Lady Falcons on top with 4:43 left to go here in the first half. Back to Williams, over to Engelkins. Engelkins might have got away with one. They go back door to Hawkins. Hawkins meets up with Lala, however, won that battle. Bree gets through three to the hoop. She goes, won't go. Engelkins comes out with it. That was Watson with the board. It's Watson pulling up from the free throw line. That could force a timeout. Does just that. 30 seconds. 25-22, Kaskaskia leads. We'll take a 30-second break. Be right back.
So, what would you like to do?
Well,
they say life's a journey, so no matter what road you travel down, or paths you take, yours begins at Red Lake College.
Something that generally is against his... against the grain for him, but very good timeout. Spot out front finds Clayman. Clayman, who Kaskaskia hasn't seen much, could floater by Kate won't go. Rebound brought down by the Blue Angels. Ingelkins brings it up. Kaskaskia leads by a three-pointer over to Hawkins. Taylor outside the arc tips it. It's Boyd. Over to Ingelkins. Ingelkins with a shot, won't go. Oh no, nothing that anybody wanted to see right there. As Hawkins ends up with the two, but more scary than that is the second foul on Jocelyn Taylor. So Hawkins at the line to give Kaskaskia a two-possession lead, and she does just that. She has a bulk of the scoring for the Blue Angels. It's Spot outside, finds Taylor. Taylor works inside. Ingelkins strips it. Here comes Ingelkins. Ingelkins backs up Spot there as they'll pick him up in the 2-3. Taylor over to Boyd. It's outside. The two won't go. Spot with the weak side rebound. That's a good one. Spot brings it up, but she'll check it. She finds Humphreys, a little bit of Kate Stainer magic. She waited, delayed trip. There's Clayman and Humphreys diving after everything. Clayman helps them both up, both her teammate and the opposing team. Here comes Vander and Bree back in. Spot and Taylor, who just picked up her second foul. With 2:55 left, two possession lead for the Blue Angels. It's Ingelkins, Williams, Boyd. They get it in the middle. Up front is Vander and Clayman right now. Williams over on the right side. And they skip it around to Ingelkins. They find someone lost underneath the bucket. That was Key. She gets her second bucket, Jesse Key now. And the lead is 8. Underneath the Vander. Vander works on the baseline, and we're going to have a foul. Markayla is going to line for 2. She's got 1 bucket. She has 2 free throws coming. 2:28 left to go in the half. 30-22, as the difference in the game is that the Blue Angels' shots are falling. Lady Falcons' shots are not. However, the defense is solid, and I'm a believer. That's what I always tell Coach Trosper. I believe, and I do believe. I believe we'll be here tomorrow at 6 o'clock playing Wabash Valley. 30-23, Markayla makes the first. She's got another coming. It is good. She's got 4. They bring it in. There's Clayman on the front side. Clayman Vander. It's as Ingelkins gets it to Williams. Bree comes over. Wow. Bree has the same look I've got. Bree just picked up the blocking foul. They'll send Williams to the free throw line for 2. She's yet to score in this one. It's a 6-point lead for Kaskaskia. 2:18 to go in the first half. Bree's first foul. Fouls are evened up 4-4. As Williams will take her 2 charity tosses. Short. And again, the Lady Falcons, so deep. They are very solid. as far as running people through the grinder, and they're doing just that again. It is Vander working hard with Finch. She'll get it up ahead to Bree. Bree looking. She's got Clayman. She wants Humphreys to come across. She gets her to. And there's Lala with a baseline shot called by her point guard, Bree Matthews. Stainer, Matthews, Clayman, Humphreys, Vander. Out front is Engelkins. Engelkins works against the grain. Bounce pass into Williams. Clayman hangs in there just long enough, but, and you know, I hear her grandmama's listening. Oma, she loves you a whole bunch. I got to talk to her before the game, and she just plays so hard. And I know you're there with her family. Shout out. You guys do some really good work. Really, really good work. Three-pointer up by the Blue Angels, and again, they just can't miss anything. Key makes that. The lead back up to 7, 33-26. Here comes Kate. Kate hands off to Clayman. Clayman turns around. She'll have Engelkins to face. 19 on the shot clock. Loses the handle. Gets it back. It's going to be a takeaway. Key loses it. Gets it back. And it's going to be Kaskaskia's basketball. As that was just an unfortunate situation there. We may have a flip around. Spot's going to check back in. She'll check in for Olivia Clayman. It's going to be Kaskaskia's ball, as all they did was change it to a tie-up. Kick's called. Let's see. So it's going to stay Kaskaskia's ball as possession now changed back to the Lady Falcons on the call reversal. Up it is. Humphreys gets hammered. Nothing there. It is back to Watkins. Watkins back out to Engelkins. Engelkins out front. Man-to-man for the Lady Falcons. Nope, it's a 2-3 zone matchup. Down to Engelkins as they work against, they work in the flex, thinking they were against a man. Watkins loses the handle, and that was determined before it came out of bounds. As a 7-point lead for the Blue Angels, and it comes to Kate. 48 seconds left in the first half. Spot has it now, left side. She'll come across off a screen from Vander. Matthews has it stripped on a errant pass. Boyd will find Engelkins, and that one was not positive for the Lady Falcons. It's the biggest lead of the game, 9-4 Kaskaskia. Vander works off the block. Humphreys with the rebound. Lala coming up big here. She has 5. As with 12 seconds left in the first half, Engelkins goes to Boyd. Boyd met by Stainer on the block. Good defense by Kate. Lala with it. They got to hurry. Vander's shot is no good. She did get it off in time, though. And at the half, wow, 35-28. Kaskaskia leads the Lady Falcons.
No matter who you are, where you want to go, or what you want to be, your journey starts at Ren Lake College.
She had 10 first quarter points, had to set for a bunch of the second quarter. Matthews has 4, 5 for Lala, a couple of those off offensive boards, 5 for Thompson, and 4 for Vander. Kate Stainer also being her remarkable self. Olivia Clayman and Jolia Spott also. Big roles here for the Lady Falcons as they look to climb back in this. And again, I think after the first 2-3 minutes of this one, we'll feel a lot better. I know I will. It's 35-28. Lady Falcons looking to advance in the Region 24 tournament. They are facing Kaskaskia right now. Kaskaskia gave them one of their 2 conference losses as Kaskaskia got them at home right after Christmas break. Of course, Wabash Valley is the team that's already poised and ready to play at 6 o'clock on Saturday evening against the winner of this one right here, as it looks like the Lady Falcons are getting that hoop uncovered. As I like the way they're warming up, we're going to go ahead, finish out our halftime spots, and we'll be right back with the second half in just a moment. Lady Falcons trail here, 35-28. Thank you to the Stainers for the warm message about Sonny, and I will try to ease up on him a bit, as probably the reason he has any trouble. But we got to have a big comeback here. It is a 7-point deficit for the Lady Falcons, 35-28. And from what I understand, folks, you can catch some of this on YouTube. I'm not sure exactly who. Wren Lake College YouTube, if you want to catch us broadcasting and doing the audio, you can catch that too. So, I mean, see if I'm calling it right. That would be a good deal. 35-28 is our score. Halftime brought to you by the Medicine Shop, Southeastern Illinois College. Bex Drugs and Medical Equipment. As we get ready, here comes the most important part of the game to me. And Logan laughs at me about it, but I really do believe it. Coach Strasper, I'm not worried anymore. I just saw him smile for the first time in this game, and I've been waiting for that smile. Got to talk to Coach Taylor prior to the game and asked him if he'd seen him smile the first year, and nope. So it's not something I make up, folks. It's going to be Taylor, Stainer, Matthews, Humphreys, Thompson coming out. Lady Falcons will have it. Then remember that was on that call earlier that wasn't necessarily reversed, but it kind of was, I guess, because it was undeterminable. So it went to a alternate possession, which gives the Lady Falcons the ball, and Thompson called for the double dribble. She drove to the hoop. 35-28 is our score, 9:52 to go in the third, and they come to Williams. Pressure by the Lady Falcons. They go out to Williams. Key had it for a moment. As Taylor, oh, they back out of it. It's going to be Humphreys. Engelkins gets ahead of it. Oh, wow. If you guys are watching on YouTube, you'll know where the oh, wow came from. Kate, up ahead, gets it from Bree. Over to Taylor. Taylor working in the paint, up and over the top, won't go. Taylor's second effort is good. Jocelyn with a bucket. The score, 37-30. Bringing it up, Engelkins, and that was just, yeah, I saw that too, Coach. That was just a tremendous push-off. Blocked shot by Lala. 37-30, 9:05 to go in this contest as Kaskaskia has it out of bounds underneath their own bucket. They'll bring Key to bring it in. She's got Williams. They bring it in to Williams. As a matter of fact, back to Key, underneath to Hawkins. Hawkins faces Humphreys. She'll kick it out. They drive Engelkins with a three ball. Won't go. Rebound. Hawkins. It's wow. It's Orlandra Humphreys with just a block. It was about a foot and a half out of her hand when she swatted it down. 37-30. Kaskaskia has the basketball underneath their own bucket. We're in the third quarter. They go back to Williams. Kate Stainer with a block of her own. She'll find Lala. There's a flip. Here's Lala with it. She looks for trailers. Back to Bree. Bree Matthews gets Taylor. Taylor works off Key as her left-handed hook shot won't go. Key stays with it. She'll haul in the rebound. 7-point leads. Same place we started. Opening this second half. It's Key off the side of the glass. Thompson with the rebound. Here comes Bree. Bree Matthews back to Taylor. Taylor with a turnaround won't go. Lala battling as she'll take it herself. Lala with a rebound bucket. Timeout called. Coach Trosper happy on this. It's a 5-point differential. 37-32 is our score. We'll take 30 seconds and be right back.
So, what would you like to do?
Well,
they say life's a journey. So, no matter what road you travel down or paths you take, yours begins at Rend Lake College.
I got Deja Quick, Jolia Spot. Got all kinds of great names here. Falcons is it's to the hoop. Nice play by Kaskaskia as driving it home, making it a 7-point lead again, 39-32. Lala with a two ball won't go. Rebound brought down by Watson. Williams works on Matthews as she'll send her left side back to Engelkins. Engelkins out front, 39-32. Thompson with another great defensive play as it is. 12 seconds to go. Boyd with it for Kaskaskia. She'll work on Taylor. Drive through. Wow. What a play by Boyd. As that fell, the biggest lead of the game, 9, belongs to Kaskaskia. It's Taylor out front. She's got Finch on her. Taylor will scoop through. Finch, Taylor, battle. Taylor comes up with it. Nothing on the contact call. Williams will get the rebound. Here comes the Kaskaskia Blue Angels up ahead to Boyd. Kate Stainer back on the baseline. Covering that, they'll go back to Engelkins. Engelkins out front. Taylor with looking for an open court steal. Can't get her hand on it. Finch to Watson over to Boyd. Boyd, 3. Nope, they say it's a 2, and that's good news. And the lead is 11. Matthews with it outside, left side. She gets a high screen, and she'll go to the hoop. Big play, big, big, big play by number 10, Bree Matthews. She had 4 first quarter points She has been held scoreless until that moment right there where she just took it straight to the hoop. Taylor will be replaced by Vander. It's Thompson, Stainer, Matthews, Humphreys, Vander for Coach Trosper. Lady Falcons trail by 9. 6:25 left to go in the third. Finch will come out. Key comes back in, so it's Engelkins, Boyd, Hawkins, Key, and Williams for Kaskaskia as Matthews looks to make an old-fashioned three-point play here, number 10 at the line. She's got Vander and Humphreys up there with her. She will ace that one. And the lead is 8 for Kaskaskia. Williams, Engelkins. Wow. It is. It's pass cross court. Boyd with 18 on the shot clock will dribble it off her leg, I think. And 6:11 left, 43-35. Kate brings it up against Boyd. Kate finds Bree. Bree with a moment of opportunity. She'll set it up, waits. Looking for a trailer, she'll come across, finds Markayla. Markayla for three. Vander, she can shoot a little bit, just a little bit. Lead is now 5. Humphreys, and this is what I was waiting on. Just a few moments later, and I thought, Lala, shot is partially blocked. Engelkins comes up, she'll cross midcourt. She gets to the center, Lala with a block. Engelkins has been fiery, however. Late whistle. Engelkins with the bucket. She has another chance at a three-point play. As Lala just picked up foul number 2. 5:28 to go in the third. It's Stainer, Humphreys, Vander, Thompson, and Matthews for Coach Trosper and the Lady Falcons. With 5:28 left, Engelkins, who's having a game of her life, now has 6 third quarter points. Here comes Kate. She's going to go coast to coast. It does. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. As Kate goes coast to coast, there's the Blue Angels working on it. 10 seconds. Thank the good Lord. I thought they were calling a foul, but they did not. Wow. 6-point ball game, 46-40. As I thought Matthews was going to pick up the foul, she did not. That makes me extremely happy. It is Spot going to come into the ball game. Let's see, y'all. There goes Markayla. Doesn't go. Rebound. Battled for off the leg of Hawkins. Arguing her case is Key, but there's no reversal here. It's Bree Matthews with the basketball. She looks for cutters. Back she comes to Vander. Vander for another 3 ball won't go. Key with a huge rebound for the Blue Angels, and she'll bring it out. 46-40 is our score. 4:52 to go here from Ren Lake College. It's a 3 from Key. She nailed that from downtown, making it Vander with the answer. Doesn't go. Humphreys hauls in the rebound, and she'll come off the glass. Yes, Lala shows up big time right there as Lala will go to the line for a good old-fashioned three-point play of her own. You're listening to WBQ AM 1240 Lady Falcon Basketball, brought to you by the Harrisburg Vet Clinic, 1101 North Main Street. They have everything you need for your beloved pets and farm animals. It is 49-42. Foul on Hawkins is her third for the Blue Angels. First bit of foul trouble they've gotten themselves into. Lala finishes that one nicely. It's going to be pressure by the Lady Falcons. They trail by 6. Over to Key. Back to Williams. Williams to Key. Key looks to get by. She's left side. There's Spot and Taylor. They've got her in a trap. There's Vander with the takeaway. She's off and running. She's got Boyd to beat and does just that. Markayla Vander, coast to coast. And yes, Coach Trusper is just a little happy on the sidelines. Gotta love him. Coach Kaskaskia coach wants a timeout. And with that, we'll take 30 seconds. 49-45, 4:11 left in the third, back in 30.
No matter who you are, where you want to go, or what you want to be, your journey starts at Ren Lake College.
That was our score. Again, Lady Falcons done everything you need to do, with the exception of the fact that there was a kind of a cover on the bucket for most of the first half, as they try to get back to a one-possession game. Spot Vander, it's Matthews with it. Humphrey sets a high screen for Bree. It's Bree works off Williams. She'll have it tipped, gets it back. She goes to Lala. Lala off the baseline. Her floater won't go. Vander, who's been huge off the bench, comes up with nearly a great play. They say she stepped on the baseline, however. So we'll see that Falcon pressure. Spot and Matthews up front. Second row is Taylor and Vander. Humphreys roaming the backside. As Kaskaskia up ahead, they go to Watson. Watson gets by. She'll hold it up, get it to Engelkins. Engelkins having a great game for the Blue Angels. Out, it's going to be Vander. Vander with the takeaway. She'll pull up, shoot the jumper, won't go. Tipped. Boyd with it. Boyd tries to get by Taylor. Taylor from behind with a blocked shot. It will stay with Kaskaskia, but what a blocked shot. Very brave move by Jocelyn. As she had to stop him somehow, she just waited, snuck in on the backside. 49-45 is our score, 3:30 to go in the third. Kaskaskia has the ball in the four-point lead. Lady Falcons here from the Region 24 tournament at Ren Lake. Williams out front, down to Watson. Watson draws, and that is one that, wow. That's a wow one. If you're listening to us on YouTube, you know why that's a wow one. 49-45 is our score. 3:18 left to go in the third. Foul is called on Taylor, as she nipped that last one in the bud. Got this one, though, and Watson at the line for two. 49-45, four-point lead for Kaskaskia, as the Blue Angels in and out for Watson. She'll have another toss coming. Free throws are premium in this one. There's been more three-point shot free throws than anything else. Watson has another toss coming. 49-45 still our score. Lady Falcons trail with 3:18 to go in the third by four, as Watson tries to make it five and does just that. One of two from the line there. Spot over the top. Michaela to Humphreys as the Lady Falcons sneak by the defenders. And Lala now has seven. They take it away again. It is tipped out of play. As I hear Tom, please, you gotta love it. Coach Taylor, Tom Fleege, that was some defense now. I love this team. And they bring it to Matthews. It's a three-point ball game. 47-50. Make it 50 off. Make it tied. Because Matthews just went, and they're doing their three-person wave right over there. Bree just nailed a three. Here it is. Humphreys, Thompson up ahead. There's Vander. She looks for separation. Michaela going to town. We're tied at 50, and Michaela's going to the free throw line for a couple tosses. 50 all's our score. As I'm very much enjoying the three-person wave. As Vincent's folks come in, and again, hats off to the Wabash Valley crew for letting me just step in and use their equipment for this one, as Michaela makes it a first time in a long time Lady Falcons have the lead. Michaela knocks down her first free throw. She's the one I'd want, as I feel much better now that Trust was smiling. Woo! Yes, 52-50 is our score, and they come to Key over to Engelkins. Engelkins meets a plethora of Falcons. 2:38 left in the third, 52-50 is our score. Down it goes to Key. Key loses the handle. Bree finds it. Off to Watson. Watson to Engelkins. And here it is. Spot ties it up. What hustle. What hustle. Just flat hustle. As the Lady Falcons, exactly, cream always rises to the top. And the defense, I'm telling you, that bucket was covered for them. But it's uncovered now. I can see it. Coach Trosper smiling, having a big old time over there with Coach Kennert. Gotta love it. Engelkins picks up her dribble. Over she goes to Williams, down to Watson on the baseline. Back it is. Key with it. Jesse Key over to Engelkins. 8 on the shot clock. And this could make them crazier than they already are. And it is. It's going to make them crazier. Engelkins shot won't go. They're going to, wow. They do call it on the 30-second clock. Not sure about that one. Yeah. We are minute 56 to go here in the third. Spot, Joe Spot brings it up. She'll find Lala. It won't. Oh, and just an errant pass. It was a good idea. Coach Trosper wants just a little more patience. However, watch that young man just develop into one of the best coaches I've ever seen. As he is just spectacular. Key will pick up the foul after Spot takes it away from her. As the Lady Falcons celebrate just a little bit, not too early. They're just celebrating a little bit. Every victory is big. It is Matthews, Thompson, Vander, Humphreys, and Spot. Humphreys will create the contact as Watson picks up the foul. Lala will, wow, as quickly the Lady, the Blue Angels have gotten into a little bit of foul trouble. Key picked up her fourth. I didn't realize that. It's Lala at the line for two. And short, she'll have another toss coming. Lala has 7 third quarter points. It's okay, Lala. We'll mind if you get some more. As she came out big time here in this recovery in the third quarter. Lala's free throws, nothing but net on the second. And she now has 9. 8, I'm sorry. It is Engelkins over to Williams. Bree Matthews got a piece of it. As they work, Vander with the takeaway. I love this defense. Matthews back to Spot. Joe with the drive out to Vander. Vander, who stole it in the first place. It's going to be Williams. Good job by the Blue Angels of hitting the boards there. They needed that stop. 53-50 is the score. 1:13 left to go, third quarter. Boyd out front. Spot gets a piece of it. And again, Spot to the hoop. Boom, chakalaka. Gotta love it. Timeout versus Coach Trosper. Having a little fun over there, just a slight bit. I like it. As we have a break, 55-50, 1:02 left to go. We'll stay right here, though, as it's just a short timeout. And talk to you a little bit about what's up and coming. Should the Lady Falcons continue here on this trip? 55-50 is our score right now. Again, you hear me talk about Tom and Sharon Fleege. There's reason. Folks, we need more folks like Tom and Sharon. Come out and watch more than a 3-person wave. If they could get the softball coach from across the way, Coach Taylor, they could have 5, 7, maybe 10 folks doing the wave with them. But these kids need folks that support them. And Maybe they didn't start local, but they're local now. There are kids, and they are amazing. This program and what they've done to turn things around there at Southeastern. And if you like basketball that's played hard-nosed, that's played unselfishly, where they average 20 assists a game and 20 takeaways a game, the sister's right. The takeaways may be a little fabricated, but pretty doggone close. It is. Bree Matthews, spot Ed Vander working on Ingelkins. Ingelkins will dribble out of the trouble. 5-point lead for the Lady Falcons. They trailed by 7 at the end of the half. 10 seconds left. No look there. Spot again with a takeaway. She finds Matthews, and I don't know how. Vander for 3. Doesn't go. Ingelkins gets the tip ball. She'll bring it up. She gets by one defender. Let's see who that was on. Not sure. No, not a shooting foul, however. Key's going to come back in as regardless. I know she's got 4. It was Spot that picked up the foul. Underneath, Williams will bring it in. She gets it to Watson. Watson will drive by Humphreys, and she'll get a bucket. 55-52 is our score. There's Matthews with it. We have winding down here in the third quarter. Last shot will be the Falcons, unless something crazy happens. They lead by 3, 55-52. Coach lost her. Oh, no. Coach wanted the separation, so did I. They call Lala over the bat, and that's her third. 2.3 seconds left, and a score here could be not a good thing. They go to Finch. Finch goes. It's Lala. Oh, and they didn't get the shot off. They took it away again. We end up the third with the Lady Falcons leading this one, 55-52. We got.
So, what would you like to do?
Well,
they say life's a journey, so no matter what road you travel down, or paths you take, yours begins at Lend Lake College. No matter who you are, where you want to go, or what you want to be, your journey starts at Lend Lake College.
Basketball to open the fourth. Man-to-man for Kaskaskia, and again, winding down the game. The Falcons are deep. Spot, who's had a huge defensive game, comes up with a huge offensive play, and the lead is back up to 5 for the Lady Falcons. They got him in a trap. Doesn't go. Vander, yes! They create another turnover. As watching, Coach Trusper, Coach Kenner over there on the sidelines. High intensity ball game, nonetheless, no doubt. Matthews with it. She'll get it to Thompson. It's Matthews, Thompson, Spot, Humphreys, and Vander. As Thompson's going to go to the hoop and just taken over. And again, as watching, smiling Jack Trusper. Anybody knows the man knows that's crazy. But he does smile about these kids. It is Watson off the roll, won't go, and here comes Michaela. Michaela's crossover gets by Engelkins, up ahead to Vander. Vander to the hoop, 2 points for Michaela. And the lead is 9 for the Lady Falcons. So in 11 minutes, they erase a 7-point deficit, go up by 9. Engelkins, who's been huge, she'll run into Humphreys, though. Humphreys just takes it from her. Up ahead, they go to Michaela. Michaela waits, checks her cutters. Up she goes. There's Lala. They're on the weak side board, and the Lady Falcons rocking and rolling. That three-person wave works good. I'll tell you, we'd like some more to join us, though, as the Lady Falcons again. Boyd out front. She'll go underneath. First bucket for Kaskaskia comes, and that's the one young lady I don't have a name for. Vander works off the block, doesn't go, gets her own rebound, creates the contact, and Michaela is going to the line for a couple free throws. Michaela Vander, as she goes to the line, looking back through here, she had a big first half as well. She'll go line as Kate comes back in. Taylor comes in. So right now it's Vander with 2, and the lead grows for the Lady Falcons. And you know I'm loving that. Thompson and Humphreys will get a break. As, let's see. Vander now has 8. Now she's got 12, so another Lady Falcon in double digits. She hits them both, 13, and the biggest lead of the game for the Lady Falcons. In fact, 11's the biggest lead of the game for either team. As the Lady Falcons work on the pressure, here comes Engelkins. Engelkins has her shot blocked, but Watson follows. She's a solid player, Watson is. She now has a score in the second, in the fourth quarter. Kate gets in a bit of a jam, but she just keeps playing through it. Watson with a block shot on a give and go. Kate with a nice play. Watson brings it across midcourt. 9-point lead for the Lady Falcons. Engelkins out front as Kaskaskia fights for survival. Winner of this one goes on to play tomorrow night. Vander with the kick. They'll reset it to 15 seconds on the shot clock. Out of bounds. Key will take it out. She gets it to Engelkins. Engelkins with 7:29 to go in the game. It's Boyd out to Williams. Williams back to Boyd. Underneath to Watson. Watson met by some good defense. She doesn't know that it didn't, the shot didn't hit. No, it didn't hit anything. Didn't hit anything. That's the coach is very upset. However, the shot by Watson did not touch anything, I don't think. Well, I guess we can look on YouTube later, but I don't think it did. Spot behind the back, she has it. She works around. Shot partially blocked, and it's going to be Key with the rebound for Kaskaskia. Out to Engelkins. Coach wants him to go. Watson with a big play down low. She's come up big. In this one, it's Bree Matthews crossing over in front of Williams. She gets by her defender. Back to Spot. Spot back to Kate. Oh, it's Boyd with a steal, and we're going to need a stop. Stainer with a great job defensively. Slides back to the backstop, as that was a huge stop right there. 65-58 our score. Bree finds Taylor. We're not going to get many whistles here late. I don't look like it. Watson over to Engelkins. Engelkins works down to Watson. Watson Stainer there on the weak side board. Up ahead, Spot. They'll turn it over as Engelkins, who's had a huge game. Here comes Thompson and Humphreys. They'll come back in. Vander and Spot will take a moment. All an out effort for the Lady Falcons. As watching Coach Taylor coach from the sidelines. He loves these kids, too. They're just a good group of guys and girls and gals out there at Southeastern, folks. You need to meet them. Come out and see them. You'll like them. Williams with it out front. Coach from Kaskaskia has calmed down a little bit. However, they turn it over on the calm down. It's Key chasing Matthews. She can't catch up. Bree with a bucket. Time. We have a, nope, just an errant whistle. They just wanted the ball back. 67-58. Three possession, 9-point lead for the Lady Falcons. Ingelkins skips it to Williams. There's Kate. Back to Watson. Ooh, barely. I mean like half a second. Williams out front. She'll bring it back around. There's only 14 seconds on the clock. Key with a shot that won't hit anything. Thompson keeps the Blue Angels off of it. And it'll go back to the Lady Falcons. 5:34 to go. You're listening to BBQAM 1240. Kelly Mason here at the studio. Everybody helping on production back there. And sure do appreciate it. This is a lot of fun, folks. Kate crosses over in front of Ingelkins. As she's at the volleyball line, she'll look to Humphreys. Lala gets it back to Bree. Bree with it, 16 on the shot clock. She directs traffic, turns it around. There she goes to the hoop, and nothing but good. That's why they double-teamed her in the first half, or triple-teamed her some of the time. It is 69-58, back to match. Here comes the biggest lead. As Michaela goes to the hoop after the steal, it's Thompson forcing the timeout. No, maybe not. Maybe Jack just called it. Timeout called. Lady Falcons lead by 13 with 4:54 to go in this one. Oh, I feel better now. We're going to go ahead and take a 30-second break. We'll be right back in 30 seconds.
So, what would you like to do?
Well,
they say life's a journey, so no matter what road you travel down, or paths you take, yours begins at Lem Lake College.
It was scaring me for a moment. Now I'm okay. Pressure mounts. It's Watson with it. She looks to split the defense. Her floater, she's been quite a thorn, but it's going to be Humphreys to Matthews. Matthews with a baseball pass. Oh, but Michaela. And she did. She was so excited as the Lady Falcons having fun. And that is way cool to see. I don't know how Matthews saw her. I don't know how Michaela caught it, but she did travel with it. Lady Falcons up by 13, under 5 to go, 4:25 in fact. And it's going to be Kaskaskia's ball after the tip out as 20 seconds on the shot clock. 71-58 is our score. You're listening to WBQAM 1240 as we're at Region 24 playoffs. Here at Ren Lake. They call it District P. I don't exactly know what District P is, but that's what they call it. Over they go. Ingelkins. Shot doesn't go. Michaela and Humphreys right there for the weak side board. It's going to end up in Michaela's hands. Stainer gets it to Bree. Bree brings it across as they'll take a little time. They won't slow things down a bunch, but nothing. Oh, wow. Wow, that travel call at the free throw line on Lala. As the pressure continues for the Lady Falcons, Watson to Boyd. Boyd on the breakaway. She's going to get slowed up by Kate and Lala. It's Matthews on Watson, back to Engelkins, over to Williams. Williams with it, left side of the court, back to Boyd, over to Engelkins. Back to Williams, Williams at the top. She'll go to Engelkins. Engelkins' shot is off the mark, and that's why, yeah, get out of the way, Coach Taylors. Thompson likes to run, almost ran into her. But Michaela Thompson, that's what she does, whatever it takes. And you heard me say her name a bunch here as of late. Weak side board, big board, big board. She take it away. There you go. That's Michaela. She's got it right now. She gets it to Taylor. Taylor's three. Doesn't go. Boyd with the rebound. And that's 3 minutes left in this ball game. Lady Falcons just need a couple stops to make it all go good. Key might have got away with a travel or two. Watson with the rebound and that kind of stuff. Or Key with the rebound. Two travels and something there. 11-point differential. Here comes Taylor. Taylor works off Key. Foul's called. Taylor going to the line. Jocelyn Taylor. This has been such an incredible group of young ladies to watch play basketball, to interact with one another and with folks out at Southeastern, to hear their teachers and the security, I say that, not meaning they needed security, but there's always security, to watch the men and ladies out there comment on this group of young folks right here that can't kick them out of the gym. And right now, with 2:40 left, they lead by 11. Taylor is at the free throw line. She missed her first. They trailed by 7 at the half. But just an amazing group of young folks. That's good from Taylor. So the lead back up to 12. Biggest lead of the game was 13. Spot comes back in. She's earned a spot. As I'm still laughing at my YouTube man over here from Room Lake that thought I made up these names. Spot. And yeah. It is Bree and Vander got them in a tight group. They get it up to Boyd. Boyd to Watkins. Watkins with a bucket. And it is now 10-point ball game. 23 seconds on the shot clock. Spot will get it to Bree as they go smaller here. Bree with it. Williams on her as they work the perimeter. Matthews drives. She'll get it out to Vander. Vander, 9 on the shot clock, works it down and off the board with a great jump shot. Markayla Vander keeps coming through. Engelhardt to Boyd for the, oh, wow. They wanted the carry. They didn't get it. Williams back to Boyd. Boyd from three, in and out. Spot Humphreys. I mean, Lady Falcons want the ball. Bree Matthews, sorry for the laughter, guys, but she really wanted to throw a baseball pass. She held back. Kate Stainer getting ready to check back in. At the next break, you're listening to us on WBQ AM 1240. Bree is fouled, and she'll go to the line. As I watch my three-person wave over there, you gotta love them. Kate comes back in to the game as Bree will get a rest. We've got a minute 25 left. It's a 12-point lead for the Lady Falcons. And I was not happy until I saw Trosper smile. That's what I get for giving him so much of a hard time. Takeaway, Thompson tries to take it back, but Kaskaskia will end up with it. They better hurry. Ooh, they might not have made it if they was watching. Humphreys is Watson, who's had a great game for the Blue Angels, goes to the hoop. 10-point ball game. Vander's fouled by Boyd. And Markayla will go to the free throw line. You're listening to us on WBQ AM 1240. Lady Falcons, in all our best estimates, if they can hold on for the next minute five. Hawkins with a huge foul, and that's exact. I love that Coach Trosper. He's a pretty smart dude. As there's a reason he might have got Brielle there. Markayla's going to the free throw line for two. Fifth foul, not a foul called on the Lady Falcons in this quarter. as they lead by 10. Markayla's looking to a little more breathing room. That was pretty. And we're getting closer to 6 o'clock Saturday every moment. It's 75-64. Markayla calmly knocks them both down. I love this team. Let's see, Coach. Yep, well, wow. Took a while to get that timeout, but they did finally get it. As with 59.1 seconds left, 76-64, Lady Falcons up by 12.
No matter who you are, where you want to go, or what you want to be, the journey starts at Ren Lake College.
Yes, sir. Thank you. I think they just like you when you're around. They shot really well. But we'll take a – Coach said he wanted at least a one-point win. He'd really like 10. So they got to make a couple stops. There's the first stop. Spots knocked around. Timeout called by Coach Strasbury. Just wanted the timeout to keep from the turnover happening. But he said a 10-point win would make him a little bit happier. Just the stress of a one-point win. But and you guys that know Coach Strasbury, what a turnaround. What a turnaround in the program. Just an amazing difference. And again, for you folks that are listening, you parents out there, thanks for loaning us your kids, sending them to our community. And you can hear, this is sincere in my voice. I get to spend a lot of good quality time with my mama because, well, she shut down the golf course today because she wasn't missing a Lady Falcon game. And I can't fault her for that. Because it's been all it's supposed to be and more. They lead here. Looks like we're going to be playing tomorrow at 6 o'clock. 76-64 claiming in. Vander, Stainer, Humphreys, Thompson. There's Taylor Aldridge. She could have come and helped me if she just got off her tail. As, get like you know I love giving Taylor. Homecoming queen or something like that. I don't know. Weren't you homecoming queen? You were in the court, but you were, like, way up there. Yeah. Much better than David Aldridge, you know. You know I'm playing. As Mama just, she was waving at someone that day, and I was like, what in the world? Here comes Shay. Here comes Davisha. Here comes Clayman. Here comes Kate. And Vander's at the free throw line doing what she does. That coach wanted some 10 points, so he's going to get it. Maybe. If Vander has anything to say about it, he will. As she's still playing the, she's still pressing. But it's going to be a lot of fun. Again, Taylor Aldridge, golfer here, Stainer with a weak side rebound from El Dorado. Kate gets it up ahead to Shay. Shay to Clayman. Clayman, she's firing for Oma. Didn't go, but there's Davisha. Yep. You know it. She's a catcher. She's a player. Lead is 16. We've got 16 seconds left in this one, and we will be back tomorrow at 6 o'clock. Shot made by, still, we're still in the 10-point range. Vander loses the handle. Wait a minute, now they took it away. Engelhardt with nothing on the clock, fires it up. 80-66 our final. Anything you want to say to folks back home, Tate? Go ahead, talk to him for a second. Oh, I thought you said sure. It is WBQAM 1240. I got my three-person wave over there, the Fleeges and my mom. We're going to do the wave. Next time you can join us, you could just, you know, since Red Lake's not here, Taylor. I mean, but here comes Coach Trosper, and we will take care of his interview after I get my hug from Tate. As we got Coach coming up, we'll talk to him real briefly. Woo, yeah, baby. As I don't even know. Yeah, I think it. Yeah. Try him on.
Check. I can hear myself.
Oh, you did, Coach. You didn't smile till way longer than I was ready.
It took about 30 minutes before I could smile.
It was rough on me. But you know, you asked for a 10-point. They gave it to you. And just amazing, the defense.
Man, I mean, that group that had Julia. I mean, we had Jocelyn and Kate on the bench, and that group that had Julia and Mark and Bree and Michaela and Lala. I mean, they were everywhere. They were flying around. They're making it very difficult on them. And God, I mean, it was probably a nice little 5-minute stretch where it was they couldn't even get shots off.
No.
So I mean, and it was one of those things that, you know, we talked about at halftime. There was a little bit of bickering in the first half. You know, we weren't really playing the way that we normally do, and we weren't making shots. I mean, I thought our defense was good, and I thought we were getting good looks. We just weren't putting them in the basket. And, you know, when you get in this kind of postseason setting, you know, the nerves are there, and, you know, the energy is there, and sometimes it can be fueled the wrong way. But we addressed it in the locker room, and we got it. We just came back together, you know, and you can see, you know, when they got it back, right, you know, that pressure just eventually starts to build. Because I thought we were doing good things in the first half, weren't really generating a lot of turnovers. But I thought eventually it just kind of caught up, you know, and we were able to make that run in the third quarter and take the lead going into the fourth. You know, and then, you know, this team is just they're fun. You know, they're a fun group to coach. As we were down at halftime, I really wasn't worried. Because we don't score 28 in the half very often. And you can kind of see things kind of exploded there in the second half for 52. You know, and so our girls just stuck with it. You know, we talked at halftime, we kind of regrouped, and you know, all the girls were there. All the girls, they were in it. And every time out we had, it was, you know, let's do this together, let's stick together. And they fought through adversity, but, you know, they really prevailed. And I couldn't be more proud. And it's going to be a fun one tomorrow. I know it's going to be very
really
difficult.
Fun. It's going to be really fun. And, you know, you got the three-person wave up here. You've got to get Coach Taylor with them so they have more. But folks need to see y'all. They need to see what you've accomplished. And these young ladies and young men, you know, we're focused on the women right now because we're still here.
Mm-hmm.
But, folks, if you're not doing anything tomorrow, I mean, basketball's winding down, drive up to Red Lake. You will not believe what you can see. Just 6.6 miles from Green Hill Road.
Yeah, it's gonna be a very fun game. You know, Wabash is really, really good, and I thought we both were tested today. Each of us were tested, and I think we both kind of answered the bell. You know, and I thought they did an incredible job there against John A. Logan. You know, so I thought it's gonna be tough. It's gonna be very tough. They're 29-1 or 30-1 for a reason. I mean, they're good and they're deep and they're talented, and we know we're going to have our hands full. So, you know, we're going to enjoy this for about 10 minutes, and then by the time we go home, we've got to be worried about Wabash. So, I mean, we don't have a lot of time in between, so we'll play again tomorrow at 6, and so all our focus is now on Wabash and just trying to take care of that game and see what happens.
And see what happens. It's going to be.